Hi viewers, in this video I am going to explain how to calculate interest. Already I have uploaded a video of interest calculation where I have explained what is hire purchase system, the important terms under hire purchase system, and how to calculate interest when cash price, installment amount and rate of interest is given. So this video is a continuation of that video. If you have not watched that video, the link I have given it in the description box. Do watch that video for a better understanding. We shall discuss how to calculate interest if the rate of interest is not given and the cash price is not given. Already in the previous video we saw how to calculate interest under this method. Now we will see how to calculate interest when rate of interest is not given and cash price is not given. I have taken a problem for example. A television set, cash price of which is 18,000, is sold on hire purchase system for rupees 20,000, payable in 4 quarterly installment of rupees 5,000 each. The first payment is made at the end of the first quarter. Show how interest is calculated. Okay, now first let us see what are the information that is given in the question. See, in the question cash price is given. See, the cash price is rupees 18,000. Then higher purchase system, that is higher purchase price is given, it is 20,000. 4 quarterly installment of rupees 5,000 each. So there is installment amount, 5,000 rupees is the installment amount. The first payment is made at the end of the first quarter. Show how interest is calculated. So we have cash price, we have higher purchase price, installment amount, but rate of interest is not given in the question. So if rate of interest is not given, how are we going to calculate the answer? So the first step is we have to calculate the total interest. Before calculating what is the interest for each installment, we are going to calculate what is the total amount of interest that is paid. That is very simple because I have already told you when I was talking about the important terms in hire purchase system, interest is nothing but it is the difference between the cash price and hire purchase price. The difference between higher purchase price and cash price will give you interest. In this question, we have cash price. See, cash price is 18,000, higher purchase price is 20,000. Just substituting the figures in the values, that is higher purchase price 20,000, cash price 18,000. So you will get interest 2,000. This is the total interest paid by the hire purchaser, buyer to the seller. Okay, after calculating this interest, we are going to calculate the interest for each installment. For that, I have taken this table. In this table, we have 5 columns. Particulars column, installment column, outstanding balance column, ratio column and interest column. Okay, the particulars column will tell the details about the what we are going to enter in the rest of the columns. In the installment column, we are going to enter the installment amount. Outstanding balance means the balance that is pending or the balance that is to be paid by the buyer to the seller. What is the amount that the buyer has still to pay to the seller? That is the outstanding balance. Ratio and interest, we will come at the later part of the calculation. Okay, I will talk about this later. Okay, now in the particulars column, what we are going to do is we are going to start with the first installment. When is the first installment? It is paid at the end of the first quarter. This is quarterly payment. So first installment is the first quarter. What is the amount of installment? See, we have already seen the amount of installment is 5,000 rupees. So I am writing the installment amount in the installment column. Okay. Now in the outstanding balance, what did I tell you about outstanding balance? It is the pending amount. What amount the buyer has to pay to the seller. Okay. Now we are going to make the first payment. This is the first installment and we are going to make the first payment. In this problem, there is no down payment. The first payment is the installment amount only. So what amount will be pending? What amount the buyer has to pay to the seller? The total amount, the total cash, higher purchase price is pending. So that is the outstanding balance what I have written here. Did you understand? We are making the first payment. We did not pay. We are going to pay the first payment. So what will be the pending amount? The total price. The total price is 20,000 rupees. So when the buyer is going to make the first payment, the outstanding balance will be 20,000 rupees. Understood? Okay. Now, in the second installment, when the second installment becomes due, in the installment column, I'm writing the installment amount. 5,000 is the installment amount, so we are writing the installment amount. Then we have to calculate the outstanding balance. How to calculate the outstanding balance? Look into the previous outstanding balance. We are in the second quarter. Now we are calculating for the second installment. When we are calculating outstanding balance for the second installment, look into the previous outstanding balance. The previous outstanding balance was 20,000. The buyer has to pay to the seller 20,000 rupees. So out of this 20,000, he paid the first installment. The buyer paid 5,000 rupees in the first installment. So out of 20,000 rupees, the buyer paid 5,000 rupees. So what amount will be due when we are going to make the second payment? 15,000 rupees. I hope you understood this. 20,000 was actually due. Actually, the amount due was 20,000. The buyer paid 5,000 rupees in the first installment. So what is the net outstanding balance now? 20,000 minus 5,000. 15,000 is outstanding when the buyer is going to pay the second installment. Okay, now third installment. Third installment amount is 5,000 rupees. We have to calculate the outstanding balance. See, we have to look into the previous outstanding balance. The previous outstanding balance was 15,000 rupees. When it was 15,000 rupees, the buyer paid 5,000 rupees. In the second installment, the buyer paid 5,000 rupees. So 15,000 was outstanding. The buyer paid 5,000 rupees. So now the outstanding balance is 10,000 rupees. You understood this? Initially, 20,000 was outstanding. A payment of 5,000 was made. So 15,000 is outstanding. Again, 15,000 is outstanding. A payment of 5,000 is paid. Now the outstanding balance is 10,000 rupees. So as and when a payment is made, we are reducing the amount and calculating the net outstanding balance. So simple it is. Okay. Now the last installment, fourth installment is the last installment. We are writing the installment amount in the installment column. Okay. 10,000 was actually outstanding. When we are going to make the fourth installment, when the fourth installment is to be paid, 10,000 rupees was outstanding. Out of which we paid 5,000 rupees. The buyer paid 5,000 rupees. So now what is the outstanding balance? Now the outstanding balance is 5,000 rupees. So is it clear? Calculating outstanding balance is very simple and easy. If you just listen a bit carefully, you will understand this. Okay. Now ratio. How to calculate this ratio? As we don't have rate of interest, we are going to calculate the ratio of outstanding balance. So how to calculate this ratio? See, I have taken the outstanding balance here. The outstanding balance for the first installment is 20,000 rupees. I have written it here, 20,000. Outstanding balance for the second installment is 15,000. So I have written 15,000. For the second installment, it is 10,000. So I am writing 10,000 here. And the outstanding balance for the fourth installment is 5,000. So we are writing 5,000 here. Okay, now what we are doing, we are just striking off the common zeros. These three zeros are common in everything. So we are striking it off. Okay, now what answer you get? You get 20 is to 15 is to 10 is to 5. Okay, so 5 is the common divisor, isn't it? So I'm dividing everything by 5. So 5 4s are 20, 5 3s are 15, 5 2s are 10, 5 1s are 5. So this is my ratio. With this ratio, I'm going to divide the interest. Okay, so this is what I have written in the ratio column. Why have I written 4 here? Because the ratio of the first installment is 4. See in the calculation, the ratio of the first installment is 4. So I have written 4 here. How did I get 10 here? It is nothing but the total. Total is 4 plus 3. 4 plus 3 plus 2 plus 1. You will get 10 as your total. So the total only I have written here. 4 by 10. Now in the second installment, what is the second installment ratio? 3. See, in the calculation we have got 3. So 3 by 10. Then third installment 2 by 10. See, in the second installment the ratio is 2. So 2 by 10. Now in the last installment it is 1 by 10. The ratio is 1. So 1 by 10. Now by using this ratio we are going to apportion the interest. The total interest that we have already calculated is 2000 rupees. This 2000 rupees we are going to calculate for, we are going to apportion for each installment. What is the interest amount that is paid for each installment? That is what I have done here. 2000 is the interest that I am apportioning it in the ratio of 4 by 10. So the interest for the first installment is 800. Then for the second installment, 2000 is the total interest, 3 by 10 is the ratio. So the interest amount is 600 rupees. For the third installment, 2000 is the ratio, 2000 is the interest, 2 by 10 is the ratio. So the interest amount will be 400. For the last installment, 2000 into 1 by 10. Your answer will be 200 rupees. So this is a very simple calculation. Hope you understood this. Okay, so I have taken this problem as example. Mr. Anbu purchased a machine by hire purchase system for rupees 30,000 to be paid as follows. Down payment 5,000, at the end of the first year 7,000, end of the second year 6,500, third year 6,000, at the end of the fourth year 5,500. Interest is charged at 10% per annum. At what value should the machine be capitalized? So this is the question. Let us see what all information is given. See, the hire purchase system for rupees 30,000, that is hire purchase price is given. Down payment is given. First installment amount, second installment amount, third installment amount, fourth installment amount. All these are given. Rate of interest is also given. So that is what I have noted down here. Hire purchase price is given, all installment down payment, all installment amount is given and rate of interest is given. So what is the missing information? Cash price is the missing information. Okay, if cash price is missing, how are we going to calculate interest? First, we are going to make a small assumption. We are going to assume that the outstanding amount is 100. The rate of interest is 10%. The same rate of interest as given in the question, the rate of interest is 10%. If 100 rupees is outstanding and 10% is rate of interest, what will be the amount of interest that should be paid? 100 into 10 by 100. 10 rupees will be the interest amount. Okay, why we have made this assumption is, we know that the installment amount includes interest. Included in the installment amount, interest is there. But we don't know what is the rate of interest. So, if 100 rupees is outstanding and if the rate of interest is 10%, the amount of interest is 10. So, the installment amount including interest will be 110. That is what I have written in the denominator. We are assuming that the outstanding balance is 100 rupees, interest is 10 rupees. So, the total is including interest, it is 110. Okay, so 10 divided by 110. We are just calculating interest. 10 is interest. Including interest, it is 110. So 10 divided by 110. This is how we have to calculate interest. If you don't understand this, I'll just give you a small tip to do this correctly. See, rate of interest, how to calculate rate of interest is rate of interest divided by 100 plus rate of interest. Rate of interest divided by 100 plus rate of interest. What I am meaning here is, whatever is the rate of interest, if rate of interest is 10%, if the rate of interest is 10%, then what is the rate? 10 divided by 110. In the denominator, we are adding it to 100. You understood? 10 divided by 100 plus 10, 110. If the rate of interest is 5%, how will you do it? 5 divided by 100 plus 5. So it will be 105. If the rate of interest is 20%, how will we do? 20, rate of interest is 20, so 20 divided by 100 plus 20, so you will get 120. So that is what I mean here, rate of interest divided by 100 plus rate of interest. If you don't understand the logic which I have given here, you can follow this method of calculating rate of interest. Now let us go into the table. I have given 5 columns in this table: year, installment, outstanding balance, interest paid, cash price paid. So here is the respective year of the installment. In the installment column, we are going to record the amount of installment for amount of each installment. Outstanding balance, as I already explained in the previous problem, it is the balance that is pending, the amount that is due by the buyer to the seller. Okay, the next is interest. I will tell you how to calculate interest. Cash prices, installment minus interest will give you cash price. Okay, so in this calculation, we are starting, usually we will start with the first payment, but when cash price is missing, we will start with the last payment. The last payment is the last installment. See, fourth installment is the last installment. So we are starting with the last payment. The year is fourth year. Okay, and I am writing the installment amount. What is the installment amount for the fourth year? It is 5,500. So I am writing the 5,500 in the installment column. Then outstanding balance. When we are paying the last installment, we have paid down payment, we paid the first installment, we paid the second installment, we paid the third installment. Now we are paying the last installment. When you are paying the last installment, what will be the outstanding balance? The outstanding balance will be equal to your installment amount, because as I already told you in my part 1 video, at the end of the last installment, the outstanding balance should become nil. You remember that video? At the end of the last installment, the outstanding balance should be nil. So it should be equal to the installment amount. Okay, so 5,500 is the installment amount. Outstanding balance will also be 5,500 only, because after paying the fourth installment, that should be a final settlement. The buyer is making a final settlement. There is no further claim. He has completely paid everything. So it should be equal to the installment amount. So this is the outstanding balance. Okay, how to calculate interest? The rate of interest we have calculated here. See, 10 divided by 110. Isn't it? 10 divided by 110 is the rate of interest that we have calculated. So whatever is given in the outstanding balance column, 5,500, that is what I've given here. 3 means the third column. This is the third column. Third column into 10 divided by 110. So 5,500 into 10 divided by 110, 500 is the interest. What is the cash price that we all know? Installment, the second column. This is the second column minus fourth column, this column. So 5,500 minus 500 will give you cash price paid. Okay, now we are moving on to the next installment. So after the fourth installment, before the fourth installment, the next will be the third installment, third year. I am writing the installment amount. The installment amount is 6,000 rupees. Now we have to calculate the outstanding balance. When we are going to pay the third installment, the amount of the fourth installment will also be outstanding. See here, the amount of, now only we are paying the third installment. Fourth installment, obviously, we would have not paid. So what is the outstanding balance? Fourth cash price and also the third installment amount, because we did not pay the third one. So third one and the fourth one will be outstanding. So the third one is 6,000 and the fourth one amount is 5,000. 6,000 plus 5,000, 11,000 is the outstanding balance. On this 11,000, we are calculating interest. 11,000 into 10 divided by 110, 1,000 rupees will be the interest. So 6,000 is the installment, 1,000 is the interest. So cash price will be 5,000 rupees. Then second year, second installment. Second installment amount is 6,500. When we are going to pay the second installment, what all amount will be due? Second installment amount will be due, third installment will be due, and fourth also will be due. That is what I have done here. 6,500, so I have written 6,500 for second installment. Third installment is 5,000. I have written third installment 5,000. Fourth installment 5,000. So that also I have written here. So 6,500 plus 5,000 plus 5,000 will give you 16,500, the outstanding balance for the second installment. This outstanding balance 16,500 into 10 divided by 110 will give you the interest amount. Then installment 6,500 minus 1,500 will give you cash price paid. Okay, then first installment. When the first installment is to be paid, first installment amount is 7,000. When we are going to make this first installment amount, what all will be due? First installment will be due, second, third, fourth, everything will be due. So first installment amount is 7,000, second is 5,000, third is 5,000, fourth is also 5,000. So I have added everything here, 7,000 plus 5,000 plus 5,000 plus 5,000. So total outstanding balance is 22,000. This 22,000 into 10 divided by 110, 1,000 rupees will be the interest amount. Cash price is 7,000 installment amount minus interest amount, cash price is 5,000 rupees. Okay, the next payment is down payment. Down payment is 5,000 rupees. For down payment, we did not calculate interest. Why? Down payment is paid immediately soon after signing the agreement. Interest will be paid only for delayed payment. Okay, that is why we are calculating interest for first, second, third and fourth, because it is delayed payment. But down payment is paid immediately, so there is no outstanding balance and there is no interest, so no need to calculate outstanding balance. You understood? If we have to calculate interest, we have to calculate the outstanding balance. Since there is no interest for down payment, we are not calculating outstanding balance. We are writing the amount in the total cash price column. So if you add the last column, cash price column, 5,000, 5,000, 5,000, 5,000 and 5,000, you get 25,000, which is the cash price that is paid. So you understood. We have learned how to calculate interest if rate of interest is not given and cash price is not given. I have uploaded another video which explains how to calculate interest when installment amount is not given. And another method, annuity method, which is totally different from the other four methods. For this, I have uploaded a separate video. Hope you found this video useful. Thank you for watching.